Hey guys, Audrey Cleo here for Young Hollywood. NBC's Crowded centers on a couple whose adult kids move back home. And we've all been there, right? Or maybe just me. Letting me just chill out on your couch. I don't know.
It's a really comfy couch. I've taken many a nap on this couch.
Have you really?
Yeah.
Well, if you don't recognize him, you definitely recognize his voice, Patrick Warburton.
Can I fix anything?
What can you fix me?
Well, have you ever smelled the inside of a non-working refrigerator?
I have not.
Carrie Preston?
Yes.
Hello.
Hello.
It's been crowded on the set, shall we say.
I know. You like what I did there?
You know, we're trying to figure out what works and what doesn't work on the set, like in real life.
Yeah. We were about to have a cup of coffee and we didn't know if we should push the buttons or not, or if that plug even, you know, produced electricity.
The two of you play sisters. How close are you in real life?
It feels weird to say it.
I know.
We're really close. It's been really fun.
Yeah, it felt like really natural to be close really fast. Like we started, we already felt like a family because we had to be rehearsing together, and we went to a Dodgers game. It was Miranda's first Dodgers game like a few weeks ago.
How was it?
It was really cool. I had a great time. My favorite part was we actually got to be on the Jumbotron for 2 seconds, and it was really cool.
It's pretty awesome.
You play Mike
on
Crowded. Mm-hmm. Tell me a little bit about Mike. He's kind of in a predicament because his daughters are moving back in.
Right.
His parents are not moving. Yeah. At all.
Right.
They're staying. Now he's kind of stuck.
Yes. Well, the two gals came back from college, decided to move back in, and mom and dad are around and they're not going to leave. They were going to go to Florida, but, you know, no, they think we need their help, so they're going to hang out. I told them early on, if they want to call our show Crowded, that's fine, but it's not really crowded.
It's not that crowded.
No, we have four kids at home, four dogs, a boyfriend and a girlfriend that I think they live there. The in-laws.
They think they live there. Okay.
Well, they live there. They do live there.
Yeah. Okay.
I feed them and they sleep there most of the time.
And do they pay rent?
Nope.
Wow. Nope. When can I move in?
It's pretty easy. We've not made it, you know, we've created an environment that nobody wants to leave, so.
Yeah. How fun has it been to play this character?
Well, it's been great from day one. I mean, I read the script and I thought, oh, this is going to be a fun one.
It's a very contemporary situation that we're seeing on TV.
And, absolutely.
And I think one that's actually pretty familiar to American families right now.
I sure hope so. And if it's not, I'm happy to be able to shed light on the whole diversity of families now, and make it okay with people.
Miranda, I feel like we've seen you grow up, you know, in front of the camera. What's it like to step into roles that are a little bit more mature and you know, really kind of show where you are in your life?
It's been really fun because I went to college for a couple years and I just really missed like acting, and I love acting. That's really what I want to do. So
Patrick and Carrie are your TV parents. How do they stack up?
It's been really fun getting to work with him. Patrick's really super funny.
Yeah, Patrick's like definitely taken the father role. He like sees like guys talking to us and he gets like really protective of us. And he's like, is he bothering you and stuff? It's just so
really?
Cute. Yeah. He's a father of four, so I think it's just like
natural.
Yeah. Father mode all the time.
What's the worst roommate situation you have ever had?
Look, I didn't have a nightmare roommate. My roommate was a buddy of mine, is a buddy of mine, still one of my dear friends this day. We and I had it good. Mm-hmm. We lived across the street from the beach in Santa Monica, and all we had to do was knock out a commercial or two a year, and that would pay for beer, food, rent, go out, shoot pool at night, you know, hang out, talk to the ladies, and then we go.
Did you do that move a lot too?
Just hey. And then a year later, I was married with a child, living in Van Nuys, a condo with a mortgage payment. And wondering, how did that happen so fast?
You know, I've had good roommates who had bad boyfriends. So, you know, there's been that where the boyfriend doesn't leave. And, you know, you're in a basement apartment and their bedroom is like right next to your bedroom.
Ooh.
And you're hearing way too much.
Yeah.
You're having to share a bathroom with somebody you did not sign up for.
No.
Yeah, so I've definitely had those.
But those days are behind you.
Definitely. Thankfully. I like my roommate now. He's my husband. Michael Emerson?
Yes.
He's a very good
very,
roommate.
Very, very talented.
Very
Michael
good roommate.
I don't do roommates. Now, I have been married, and I was in a relationship where somebody lived with me, and I don't think I'm good at it. I don't think I'm a good roommate, only because of the fact that I've spent so much of my life alone, not alone, but being an only child and not sharing and not really. I have great social skills. I'm a great friend, but you come into my space and all of a sudden, it's not, it's just not comfortable for me.
When I first moved here, this is all my mom's fault. She like found someone on Craigslist.
Always the best place to find roommates.
Exactly. Yeah. And so I went and like the girl's mom was there and it seemed normal. And then it turned out it was like single white female. So I'm like really happy to still be here.
I have my own place, but I basically live with my parents. I stay at my parents' house most of the time. So I'm basically living this show. So it's, I can relate to it a lot. And sometimes my mom's not the best roommate. Most of the time we get along pretty well, but sometimes it's weird just because I'm 22 and I'm still like living there. But I mean, it's nice to have like my own place to go to. Like sometimes if I get an argument with my mom, I'll just like run to my house. I'll be like, I'm going to my house. Like that's my big threat.
It's 10 feet away.
I'm not coming back till tomorrow.
The lovely Carrie Preston plays your wife. Mm-hmm. How does she stack up to the rest of your TV wives? I mean, you're kind of racking them up, aren't you, Patrick?
I've had the great fortune of having amazing TV wives. Megan Price, Julia Louis-Dreyfus, not my wife. Mm-hmm. We just were dating, okay. And then we would break up. Mm-hmm. We broke up a lot, mostly she did.
Yeah. Wow, way to be diplomatic about it.
That was putty. I was channeling Piper Sagan. She was just really hard to deal with.
Yeah.
Yeah, the chick was whacked.
So Carrie is not whack.
Carrie's
is what
not
you're
whack.
Saying.
No.
In Hollywood, that's a major compliment.
Right, right. Oh, very much so.
Yeah.
But compared to your TV husband.
Yes.
And you've had a couple.
I've had some.
You've had some boyfriends who maybe didn't really work out.
Yeah, I've had some that turned into serial killers, whatever.
Yeah, you know.
Yeah, he's not a serial killer.
I heard you like the social media.
Social media. I'm the one at the age of 60. I am the one that's introducing everybody on the set to Periscope.
No.
Can you? I know.
Really?
How did that happen?
She is really into social media, and yeah. I didn't know what Periscope was until she told me.
So sometimes she'll just pop out of a corner with her phone out, and I'm like, what are you doing? And she's like, I'm Periscoping, and I'm like, what is that?
So I think you ladies are going to give me a little bit of a tour of your TV home.
Yeah.
This is the living room. This is where a lot of the family discussions take place.
Family meetings?
Yeah.
Okay.
I want to feature an embarrassing photo of Miranda.
That's
okay. This has been photoshopped a little bit for an episode, but I just really think we need to...
Show it.
Zoom in there.
What is that even?
I know, it takes a second to kind of.
Here's a picture of me when I was little.
Adorable! Look at that.
Here, maybe we could go to the kitchen. They photoshopped this picture of me and I together.
I was going to ask because I was like, either you were childhood friends or it's just really, really good Photoshop.
It's really good Photoshop, yeah. So funny.
And then there's the set fridge.
Fake food.
All fake food, yes.
Yeah.
Smells lovely.
Warm yogurt's really good to act while you're acting.
Awesome. So every set also has like the stairs that lead to nowhere.
Yeah.
And then your secret kind of like napping spot.
Since the pilot, this is like our Miranda spot. And I, our room is supposed to be up here, our separate rooms, and this is our spot. We're always like ready
it's
before
our show.
We find it exciting.
Now, are there any spots that you like to take naps in, like to chill out?
Well, the bar set's pretty fun. But
oh, yeah, we always hang out in the bar. There.
Everyone's legal, right?
Yeah.
You guys hang out
here? Here's the bar. Yeah.
It feels like a real bar hangout.
We kind like of. After the shows, we've had like a pizza party and.
Yeah, we kind of hang out here, or when we, you know, start in the mornings, we'll have our coffee here and.
Treat it like a real bar.
So is that set alcohol or is that real?
Set alcohol, unfortunately, which is like water with food. Am I giving away all the Hollywood secrets?
Yeah,
am I not supposed to do this?
Yeah. Awesome. Well, thank you so much,
cool,
ladies.
Yeah. Thank you.
Be sure to catch Crowded on NBC.